As much as the Western world celebrates individuality, anonymity is an integral part of a democratic society. In countries like Bangladesh and Saudi Arabia, bloggers who have shared their secular beliefs have been imprisoned and even brutally murdered. Anonymity is the mask behind which we can share ideas, express opinions, and voice criticism without the fear of judgment, rejection, or even prosecution. There's a reason why we vote anonymously, call anonymous police tip lines, and answer anonymous workplace surveys. Considering the Snowden revelations, it's safe to assume that nearly everything you do online is being monitored. It's just a question of by who and for what reason. Although emphasis on encryption has increased as a result, there's an invisible threat to anonymity that very few are aware of. Your writing style. The idea that your writing can give away your identity has been around for some time. Handwriting analysts can attribute authors to a given text by studying unique characteristics of a person's handwriting. But as fonts have replaced pens in today's digital world, writing has become immune to the scrutiny of handwriting experts. This is where stylometry comes into play. It's the cousin of handwriting analysis. But instead of examining individual letters, stylometry looks at a person's writing style, the way they form sentence structures, peculiar words they tend to pair together, unique misspellings, and other literary quirks. One of the earliest documented uses of stylometry dates back to the 15th century. In his 1439 analysis, Lorenzo Valla proved that the document, Donation of Constantine, was actually a forgery. It was allegedly written in the 4th century, but by comparing Latin structures and vocabulary, Valla noticed the word satrap was being used to refer to Roman officials, when in fact, the word didn't acquire that context until hundreds of years later. In the 18th century, the author of the play Double Falsehood, Louis Theobald, claimed that he based it on a lost Shakespeare play. However, a 2015 stylometric analysis detected Shakespeare's psychological signature in the writing, thus suggesting that he was in fact an original collaborator. In 2008, the white paper outlining the cryptocurrency Bitcoin was anonymously published online by the pseudonym Satoshi Nakamoto, and to this day, the author or authors remain unidentified. In 2013, researcher Sky Gray ran a stylometric analysis on the original white paper against published academic cryptography articles to see if there were any stylistic similarities. The results? Several close matches found in the blog posts of Nick Szabo, a cryptography professor in George Washington University, who coincidentally had been developing a Bitcoin-like system for the past decade called BitGold. Some of the similarities included the tendency to start sentences with "it should be noted," which is found in 5.25% of all crypto papers, the expression "a level of" plus a noun as a standalone qualifier, the non-conventional use of the phrase "of course" without isolating commas, the expression "can be characterized" found in only 1% of all crypto papers, and repeated use of the word "timestamp" as a verb, and the phrase "timestamp server," which is central in the Bitcoin paper, was used in Nick Szabo's blog as early as January of 2006. According to Gray, the probability of finding the phrases "it should be noted," "for our purposes," "can be characterized," and "preclude," all used in the same paper by the same researcher, is only 0.08%. Szabo has since denied the claim, and while it's entirely possible that somebody imitated his writing style, the important takeaway here is that a very substantial lead emerged thanks to stylometry. When coupled with artificial intelligence, stylometry becomes even scarier. We all know IBM's Watson as the AI that defeated the Jeopardy champion Ken Jennings. But with just 100 words from any blog, tweet, or a post, Watson can extract an author's personality traits and cognitive characteristics, and go as far as predict what kind of movies and music you like, your shopping habits, and your social influences. As you can see, computers are not only exceptionally capable of quantifying writing styles, but have the uncanny ability to use that information in inconceivable ways. An algorithm developed by Stony Brook University claims it can predict the commercial success of a novel with an 84% success rate just by analyzing its writing style. The danger stylometry poses to activists, whistleblowers, and freethinkers is clear. Ross Ulbricht, the mastermind behind the infamous online marketplace Silk Road, was all too aware of this. At the time of his arrest, the FBI captured this image of his laptop screen as evidence. And guess what he had bookmarked on his browser? Science of stylometry. So how do we protect our writing from revealing our identities? Well, in order to defeat stylometric analysis, a piece of writing needs to be essentially scrubbed clean of its distinctive style and characteristics. Although software exists today, it's mostly technical and PC-based, and as we've transitioned to smartphones and tablets, we need solutions that can cater to mobile platforms and applications. So I've designed a concept called XKey. It's an anti-stylometric keyboard for your mobile phone or tablet that protects your identity by obfuscating your writing style so it can't be attributed back to you. It randomizes punctuation marks, substitutes emojis, and purposefully misspells words. And by using machine learning, it could even substitute words with synonyms and shuffle sentences almost like broken English while retaining the original meaning of your message. XKey is only a concept at this time, so if you have any ideas, feedback, or wish to contribute, I would love to hear from you in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.